I don't have a sweater on. Got a hoodie on. I'd like to say I'm a hoodie kind of girl, but I'm a hoodie girl on the weekends and a sweater girl during the week. I have two very distinct styles. It's called worked style and weekend style. And weekend style, I might have clothes on. I might still be in my pajamas. Hey guys, it's Wendy Valencia. I was tagged by Prudent Joy to do the sweater weather tag. If you want to know more about me and my likes and my dislikes, then stick around because I'm about to get opinionated, which I do really, really well. So if you don't know Prudent Joy, I am going to link her channel down below. She's awesome. I just absolutely love her. So make sure you go and give her some love on her channel. So I am not going to tag anyone. I am actually going to open up this tag because I think pretty much everybody has been tagged. So if you have not been tagged yet and you want to do this tag, go right ahead and let's just jump on in. Number one, favorite candle scent. Since this is sweater weather, I'm assuming it means fall candle scents. And I got to tell you, as much as I love fall and doing Halloween-y stuff and getting ready for Thanksgiving, I don't like fall scents. I don't. I'm sorry. My favorite scent palette, if you go to like Yankee Candle or whatever, it inevitably is always green or blue. Sometimes purple, but always green or blue. My very, very, very favorite scent is called Green Grass by Yankee Candle, and they discontinued it. For whatever reason, whenever I love something, like love it, like deep in my soul love it, the place discontinues it, stops manufacturing it, stops making it. It happens all the time for me at restaurants, if you can believe it. I don't know. I must have like a weird scent palette that I like or a flavor palette. I don't know. Because nobody else ever likes the same scents I do. But Green Grass by Yankee Candle has always been my favorite. The Lilac scent by Yankee Candle is also one of my favorites, but not for the smell, but because it reminds me of Bogota and it reminds Mauricio of Bogota and when we first started dating, if you want to even call it that, because we never really dated, but that's what my house always smelled like because that's the candles that I always burn. And I love scented candles. Question number two, coffee, tea, or hot chocolate? Yes, please. I actually like all three. I am currently drinking tea in my favorite giraffe mug. I drink 2 to 3 cups of coffee in the morning, depending on the day. I get up at 4 o'clock in the morning every day and I have to have caffeine to get my body started. So I drink 2 to 3 cups of coffee in the morning. Then I will drink hot tea and hot chocolate whenever I feel like it. In my family, we have the most amazing hot chocolate mix that we make from scratch. And it's, you know, powdered milk, shaved chocolate, and a bunch of other stuff. And it makes the most amazing hot chocolate. So we make that all the time, especially in the fall and winter, just because it's so yummy. And then we top it off with big whipped cream. And yeah, it's kind of addicting. Question number three, what is the best fall memory that you have? This one, actually, I had such an amazing time at Cox Farm with Mauricio and Melina this year that might actually be one of my favorites. Last year, Melina and I were raking up leaves out in the yard and I made them into a huge pile and she was jumping and playing in them and I took some pictures and that was super fun and I will remember that one a lot. So on top of that, I would say I went with my parents, we got in the car and we drove to the Shenandoah Mountains up to look at the leaves. And it wasn't the driving in the car that was pleasant. It was stopping at all the different roadside stands for apples and cider and drinking hot cider and then going up to Shenandoah National Park and seeing the trees and stopping at all the overlooks. And I'm pretty sure that we always stopped at all the overlooks because my brother got wickedly carsick all the time. So we probably did that because the Shenandoah Mountains, they're like super curvy. Number four, which makeup trend do you prefer? Dark lips or winged eyeliner? I have tried to do winged eyeliner on me a about 10 million times and it does not work. I am not good at it. So I have stopped trying. And dark lips is not something I do either. So I'm going to go with C, none of the above on me. Now on other people, I think both trends look fantastic. Number five, best fragrance for fall. I actually don't wear perfume a lot. I do like Coco Chanel, and that's a pretty fall winter fragrance. But I don't wear a lot of perfume. Number six, favorite Thanksgiving food. Wow, for someone who loves fall, I really don't like a lot of things that people associate with fall, apparently. I am not a huge Thanksgiving person. I don't like Thanksgiving food. I don't like turkey and mashed potatoes. I mean, I'm okay with all of it, but it's not fantastic. I do make an amazing cornbread sausage stuffing. Love that. For me, my favorite Thanksgiving food actually occurs after Thanksgiving. I love, love, love making turkey gumbo the day after Thanksgiving. And I don't know what it is about turkey gumbo. I could make regular gumbo anytime, but I got the recipe from a girlfriend of mine down in Baton Rouge, and it is amazing. And turkey gumbo is even better when you have a smoked turkey, which is what Mauricio is doing for Thanksgiving this year. He's going to be out there at before the sun comes up starting to smoke his turkey. So I'm super excited about that. Number seven, what is autumn weather like where you live? It is what you would imagine quintessential autumn weather, like jackets and scarves and leaves changing colors. And it is just lovely and beautiful. And I really love that aspect of autumn. It is just absolutely my favorite. It's so pretty, especially here. The colors are just so vivid and bright. Number eight, most worn sweater. I'll tell you, I don't wear a lot of super heavy sweaters because it gets hot really easily. So most of the time, the sweaters I wear are cardigan type sweaters, like black cardigan sweaters, gray cardigan sweaters. I pretty much have some sort of cardigan sweater in every single color. So this year, my go-to sweater is a knee-length white cashmere sweater that, you know, doesn't have any buttons. I love this sweater and I'm wearing it constantly. I love it with boots and skinny jeans. It just makes me happy. And like with a big scarf or without a scarf even, I adore it. Number nine, must have nail polish for the season. These are my fingernails. My must have nail polish is none. I love, love, love getting my nails done. I mean, love it, but it is not in the budget right now. And I have to have acrylics because my nails are so horrible. They just never grow. I mean, see this nail right here? These two nails are about as long as my nails will ever grow. They just don't grow. They break off. They're horrible condition. So I don't know, but they've always been like that. So I almost always get acrylics, and my favorite is French tips. I always have French tips. Love them. Number 10, football games are jumping in leaf piles. I'm going to go with optional answer C, which is nature walk. I don't like jumping in leaf piles. It kind of creeps me out. I don't know why. It always has. Even when I was a little kid, I didn't like it. And I hate football. Hate it. Mauricio loves it. So Mauricio's answer would be football, I'm sure. But watching Melina jump in leaf piles, love. But yeah, me getting in leaf piles, I don't know what it is. It creeps me out. I don't do it. But I love walking and seeing the changing colors a lot. Number 11, skinny jeans or leggings? Both, please. I like skinny jeans that feel like leggings, if such a thing exists. I love skinny jeans with boots, and I love leggings on the weekends. I do not wear leggings during the week because I don't consider leggings to be professional. So I would never, ever, ever wear them to the office, but I do like them a lot. So I would say if I had to choose skinny jeans, probably given the choice. Number 12, combat boots or Uggs? Lordy, people, these are all not me. So number 12 is going to be optional answer C, which is knee-length leather boots that have a little bit of a heel to them. I have these beautiful black boots that are like the most soft leather ever. I paid a small fortune for them many years ago. So I take care of them so they last, and I just love them. But I probably have 10 to 15 pairs of boots, maybe, like of varying heights, ankle boots and regular boots. I have a lot of shoes. There's a reason I don't spend much money on clothes, because I got a lot of it. So, but yeah, I'm going to go with fashionable boots. Like I have, oh my goodness, these blue suede boots that go up to the knee and they have about this much of a heel on them, but then they have this overlay of suede. So it looks almost like a suede leg warmer. It's super cool. I absolutely love them. Those are probably my very, very favorite. Number 13, is pumpkin spice worth the hype? Nope. Don't even like it a little bit. Not a fan. Number 14, favorite fall TV show. I don't watch TV ever. If we have the TV on, it is always Netflix and it is always whatever we are have opted to watch, whatever season, series, whatever. I don't have a, in fact, I don't even know what I would call a fall TV show. Number 15, what song really gets you into the fall spirit? I suck at this because I can't think of any songs that are fall. The only song I can think of is It's the Most Wonderful Time of the Year, but that's a Christmas song. And that's like our family's favorite Christmas song. Wake up, video's over. You can go about your day because I know all three of you that are watching this have fallen asleep. To do the sweater weather tag, and I know nobody's gonna watch this, so I'm trying mirroring my phone. It's pretty cool, except now instead of looking at myself over here, I am looking at myself down on the computer, so I'm gonna try not to look at myself. Could be hard. And that is probably one of my favorite things to drink. Whoa, can you hear that wind? It is crazy windy. Like it was so windy last night that I woke up at least 10 times because of the wind. It happens pretty much every November, but every November before it happens, I've forgotten it happens. And so when it starts happening, I always find it shocking. Yeah, that one really might.
Are you talking about me
today? God. I don't know if you can hear that, but oh my God, he just gave me complete heart failure. He is in the room directly underneath me and he is, whoa, I'm gonna have to shut that window. So Mauricio is in the room directly below me and he must have climbed up on something and started banging the ceiling. And it is literally directly under the wheel to my chair. And I could feel it when he banged on the ceiling. And I was like, where is he coming from? Oh my God, that scared the crap out of me. Wakey, wakey. It's over. If you are new to my channel, make sure you click on my big laughing face to subscribe, and I will put up two videos so you can keep on watching. This video is my latest one, and this one is one YouTube picked out just for you. So I'll see you in the next one. See ya!